I'll be back at your house if you need me, Thane.
This must be the pl-
Wait, what? Say what? Where you going, man? Oh, this is connected to the, But you know what a problem is? Well, let me tell you what a problem is. If one of them goes away, you know, Serena, not in this case, because he's connected to this area. So let's say this guy, I cannot re-recruit this guy. I had it once already. I'm not quite sure whether it was during the recording, but before the recordings, most certainly. You know, where I actually let me said, you know, let's, you know, go apart, and couldn't figure him out. But I don't think it's gonna work if I'm letting him wait here.
We've stopped. As you wish, my Thane.
We shall see. I think he will automatically go back. See? Oh, that's fine. Preferably not, you know, because of the fact that I only have Serena to boost my junk on.
Impressive, is it? If this ends up being a wasted trip, your friend Dexian and I are gonna have some words when we get back.
By words you mean bite? But you know, it is what it is. More water than fish.
No one's been here in centuries. I doubt there's any other place like it in Skyrim. It's beautiful.
Sure is. If I might say so myself.
Got the knife. Now all we need to do is track down one of those canticle trees. Hope the moths like that bark as much as Dexian said they would. I'm seeing things, you're starting to glimmer,
shining like a diamond. Oh, I must recollect all those little buggers, hey? Let's go little bugger hunting.
think that might have been what we were waiting for. Let's head back up there and see if we can read the scrolls. Okay. Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow. I could see it in your eyes. You looked about 1,000 leagues away. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it? Then it's almost over. We can finally put an end to this ridiculous prophecy. Where is this Darkfall cave? Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down. Not much. If you read any history, it shows up from time to time, but it's a hard thing to track. As far as I know, though, it's never been held by a vampire. That would be a new one. Ariel is one of the elven gods. He's with the rest of them in Aetherius. The way I've heard it, the sun represents the connection from our world to theirs. Supposedly, the bow draws its energy from the sun itself, which is why it shows up in that prophecy.
What?
I knew I heard something.
In the middle of a conversation.
This must be the place.
Oh, really? Really, Bethesda? Fuck you! Fuck her? You.
Not very impressive, is it?
That's not
if
fair.
If this ends up being a wasted trip, your friend Dexie and I are gonna have some words when we get back.
I'm not the kind of person that skips conversations, you know, Bethesda. I have to relocate all those fucking butterflies again. God fucking damn it.
Hope the moth liked that bark as much as Dexian said they would. Look at them. They've definitely taken a liking to you. And unless I'm seeing things, you're starting to glimmer. Are you okay? Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow. I could see it in your eyes. You looked about 1,000 leagues away. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it? Then it's on... Where is this Darkfall Cave? Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down. Not much. As far as I know, though, it's never been held. Ariel is one of the Elven gods. The way I've heard it, the sun represents the connection from our world to theirs. Supposedly, the bow draws its energy from the sun itself, which is why it shows up in that prophecy. And that part, I don't know. Once we have it, hopefully it'll be obvious. Who's there?
Vampires. Am I allowed to summon a dragon here? Doubts. Not much space to summon it anyways. Let's try nevertheless. You know, you can't go wrong with trying. Where is he? Did work, but it did not work. Are you sure you want to do this? Oh, wait. I don't have relenting force. So, yeah, you can summon it, but it will spawn outside. It's not particularly fair, you know. too many vampires and only one freaking follower. I mean, come on, Bethesda, fix your fucking shit. Because, you know, this on Legendary is a bit, unfair, I should add. Especially since the fact that I've tried to call the fucking dragon here, which was a relatively stupid call. Vampires, all versus me. Level 75 of a quest. Who knows what a. It's not really a good spot. But... Master vampire, regular vampires, a freaking gargoyle, Borut. A companion that dies, you know, relatively easy, hinting to Serena. If you can't win it, you gotta play it smart. Let's show that vampire the meaning of fly. Well, flight.
Is
Just use the height to your advantage. I couldn't because I fucked it up with trying to summon our good friend the dragon, but you know, it was pretty hard, I must say, you know. But the raging, you know, sometimes I rage and get used to it basically, but it comes with the package, you know. I do however wonder what we get once we get all the way to the top. That's it. An enchanted item. We did freaking do. Alright, so let's get the hell out of here before more of those vampires should turn up. There's something I hate, ladies and gentlemen, it's freaking vampires. Especially if you have to do it with one companion, you know. Because the game is a bit, you know, how shall I say, unbalanced on legendary. Enemies deal tons of damage, always, especially mages. But you, moi, you know. Even though I have one-handed at legendary 3. It's equal to about 200-ish, you know, through 300. And still, I do a shit amount of damage. It just doesn't make sense. Come on, Serena. I forgot. You stuck again? All the way up there, right? Well, that's for later. First, towards Fogwreath. remember this one. It's the archery training area.
Angie, and if you try anything stupid, I won't hesitate to put an arrow in your head. Sorry, a girl can't be too careful out here. Like I said, name's Angie, and I've been living out here for a couple of years now. I set up those targets a long time ago. I shoot at them from time to time. Don't want to get rusty with my bow. That I am. You know how to use one? Well, let me know if you ever want to practice. If you need a bow, there's one on the rack to the left of the door. I moved here from Helgen after my family was killed. At the time, I couldn't stand to be around anyone. They all felt sorry for me, and I didn't want them to. It was my problem. Not theirs. Two Imperial drunks who thought they were above the law. Already did. Part of the reason I'm living out here now. Thanks for offering, though. Don't be like them. Don't feel sorry for me. Excellent. Follow me to the targets and we'll begin. My father was rarely home, so it was my mother who actually taught me how to use a bow. Always said composure was the key to a successful archer. If you can remain calm, even in the midst of chaos, your arrow will most likely find its target. Okay, let's see what you can do. Remember to stay within the boundaries and only use the practice arrows. I have some if you don't have any. Aim for the middle target. Only use the practice arrows.
Oh, well, sorry. Didn't know it was that important. Where are those fucking practice arrows? Practice, I don't got practice.
Try and hit the middle target. Here you go. Shoot the middle. On target. Now hit the target to the left. Great shot. Now hit the target to the right. Nice shot. Right on target. Let me know if you want to practice some more. Next time we'll make it a little more challenging. Yes? Excellent. Follow me to the targets and we'll begin. My older brother took me out hunting a lot when I was little. At the time, it was difficult to keep food on the table, let alone have enough left over to sell at the market. So whenever we came across more than one deer in a single location, it was imperative we kill as many as we could. If you can learn to keep your composure and trust that each shot is true, then you should be able to quickly handle multiple targets. When I tell you to, try and hit each of the three closest targets in 8 seconds. I'll count to three and then say go. You have 8 seconds to hit each of the three targets. Draw string and get ready. 1, 2, 3...
Go!
Hey, watch it! You did it! All three targets in 8 seconds. Nice job. Let me know if you want to practice some more. Next time we'll make it a little more challenging. Great job hitting those targets. You definitely surprised me with your speed and composure. Excellent. Follow me to the targets and we'll begin. We've talked about speed and composure. Now we'll go over precision. Oftentimes, you won't be able to get as close to your prey as you'd like, and you'll have to settle with a long shot. However, with such a long shot, it's more than likely that's the only shot you'll be able to take before your prey runs off. If you find yourself in such a situation, then you need to make your shot count. Don't rush your shot. Crouch down, get comfortable, and take aim. Okay, your turn. Try and hit the target way in the back, far behind the other three. Remember to take your time and make your shot count. Try and hit the... Here you go. Shoot the fall. Be careful. Nice shot. Right on target. Let me know if you want to practice some more. Next time we'll make it a little more challenging. Yeah? Excellent. Follow me to the targets and we'll begin. We've talked about composure, speed, and precision. Now it's time to use all three at once. I'm warning you now, this challenge will be quite difficult. Just remember everything I've taught you and you should be able to complete it. It may take you a couple of tries, but that's what practice is all about. When I tell you to, try and hit all four targets in 10 seconds. I'll count to three and then say go. You have 10 seconds to hit each of the four targets. Draw string and get ready. 1, 2, 3... Watch it! Time's up. Better luck next time. Huh? Sure. I'll count to three and then say go. You have 10 seconds to hit each of the four targets. Draw string and get ready. 1, 2, 3...
Go!
Be careful. You did it. All four targets in 10 seconds. Nice job. I think I've taught you everything I know. You might even be as good as me now. Kind of scary if I think about it. Very funny. It was my pleasure. It's not often I get visitors out here, let alone friendly ones. Thanks for sticking around and keeping me company. It was nice to finally meet someone out here who doesn't want to rob you or take off your head. I know it isn't much, but here, take this bow. It was given to me by my family. It's special to me, but brings back too many painful memories. Remember, composure and speed. You don't need to see your arrow hit before moving on to your next target. Trust your shot is true.